honoring Dr. Savithri Subramanyam with the Lifetime Achievement Award. Madam, please come forward, madam. Lifetime Achievement Award on this day, the 27th May 2012, the citation is awarded to Dr. Savithri Subramanyam for outstanding contribution to society in the field of medicine. Present position, Honorary Professor of Obstetrics and Gynecology at Vijaya Postgraduate Training Center and Health Trust, Vadapalani, Chennai. Medical graduation, 1962, received Government Merit Scholarship for UG Studies and passed with distinction in ophthalmology. Post-graduation DGO 1965, MDOG in the year 1967 from Government Medical College, Nagpur, Maharashtra, and was placed first in the university. Joined Madras Medical Service in the year 1968 and worked at KGH, MMC, RSRM Hospital, Stanley Medical College Hospital, and IOG, MMC from 1968 to 1982 as Assistant Professor, OG. While in government service, 1976 was awarded the first AL Mudaliar Travelling Fellowship by the Obstetrics and Gynecology Society of Southern India to undergo training at the Institute for Research in Reproduction at Bombay. Fine-tuned clinical skills with training in endocrine with Professor Speroff in USA in the year 1982. Worked in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Ministry of Health Hospital as obstetric gynecological specialist from 1983 to 1985. Trained in IVF and vaginal ultrasound at Monash University, Australia in 1986. And also in advanced gynecology and gynecological endoscopic surgery at Kiel University, Germany with Professor Chen in the year 1995. Joined Sri Ramachandra Medical College in 1986 as Associate Professor in the OG Department and retired as HOD and Director in the year 2001. During the tenure, was responsible for setting up an undergraduate and postgraduate teaching department of contemporary good academic standard. The department trained the maximum number of postgraduates of SRMC and university, a total of 65 students at a time. A national level revision course for postgraduate exam going students was started by me, by her, and continues to be a very popular program till date. Was awarded by the University for Excellence in Teaching in the year 2001. Have been an undergraduate, postgraduate examiner in various universities. Participated in many national and international conferences and have many publications to her credit. Have contributed a chapter on eclampsia in the book Controversies in Obstetrics Management by JP Publications. A step towards preventive healthcare for women, a comprehensive women's health awareness program was initiated by her in the Sri Ramachandra Hospital. All the female patients attending the hospital in any departments were given the benefit of counseling and screening. Last position held, Director, Professor and Head of the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, Sri Ramachandra Medical College. We all know she is a life member of IME Chennai Kodambakkam, associated with the Obstetric and Gynecological Society of International from the year 1969 till date. Served as President of OGSSI in the year 1997-98. Founder member of the Indian Menopause Society. Professional objective, training lifelong learners, medical education. Personal vision of profession, rendering human and quality care to women of all ages and class. Hats off to you, madam. And now I invite our past president and secretary, Dr. Dakshinamurthy, to come forward to honor her with plate. And Dr. Vedavari Subramani, her sister, please honor her with a shawl. Our Lifetime Achievement Award, Professor Dr. Arvind, please sir, come forward to Kanada with the garland. Please come, sir.
Thank you.
I am very sure, had it not been this lifetime achievement award and the plate made about her, none of us would have known that we have an eminent professor among us. How else we can honor our own senior members if we don't respect, if we don't know our own people, our own value, who will value us? Thank you very much, madam. Please come and have a talk if you please.
My greetings to all. I thank the IMA Kodambakam, the office bearers, the president, the vice president, the joint secretary, the secretary, and all the office bearers, and also all the members for having chosen me today. It's a privilege, I think, to be a member of this society. I come here not as a professor, but with the humility of the students. I come here, my specialty is obstetrics and gynecology, but I come to know about what is recent, what is relevant, and what is good in other aspects of medicine, which helps me so much for day-to-day practice. I certainly thank you for this gracious gesture, and I think whosoever has started this idea, it's wonderful. As girls in girls' schools, we adore our teachers in my days, and we always try to emulate our teachers. We cherished a desire in our heart that someday we'll be a teacher. And it so happened that after I completed my medical education, that was the desire which I sought, and I was fortunate to get it, and that was my passion, and with God's grace, I seem to have done okay, and I'm thankful for that. A teacher is not an information bank, especially in the present days, when you have download tons of information on the internet. A teacher is the one who is able to tell a student as to what with her maturity, tell as to what is really relevant and what should be useful for day-to-day practice. It is to tell them that today this is what seems to be the best, but you don't know what is going to happen tomorrow. Keep learning. Because the hallmark of good practice is to be a lifelong learner. It is necessary also, as we go along in life, we'll keep learning. But we have to unlearn a few things too. We cannot be obstinately holding on to all the obsolete things, saying this is what we learned and we shall do only this. That kind of obstinacy goes when you realize that there are many youngsters who are much more informed, much better than I'm very aware of the very high-tech milieu that is there in clinic. But I feel very humble today to stand here in front of you because I know there are excellent clinicians, my own sister, my seniors, who I know are so good in their medical practice. Teaching is one thing. The other thing which I have adored and have been happy is that I have been able to look after women of all ages. I would say it's only very simple, realistic, ethical, and humane, which I was so happy that I feel much more dignified and sort of, I should say, renowned. And he keeps humbling me by saying, my teacher. Anyway, I am extremely proud of him. If he gives me that position, to be proud of him. And I think all of us learned it, that we have to be humane first. As I stand here, what is my request to this August gathering? we as obstetrician, gynecologist, we have a policy maker, a professor who is a, not a professor who is out now, but who is in the department, who is capable of making policies here with us. We are all striving to see how we can improve the health-related quality of life. But to you all, to you, to the women who are symptom-free, who are in a curable stage of disease, who come to you, just, they might be coming for aches and pains, what our friend used to call as KK syndrome in those days. That what is the case? KK syndrome. That's Kustal Kudichal Kodachal syndrome. Okay? So, Kaika. Okay, so that's 4K. I was made of this 2K. Anyway, but that was a very popular terminology. Let's not pass them off that way. Just take 2 seconds to say, when did you have your diet checkup? When did you see? They will certainly tell you, never ever, because I didn't have any problem. My last child was born and that's it. And who likes anyway to go to gynecologist for anything? So I get them only when they're sick. Please, if you can, motivate few patients to say that there's something like preventive care, early detection. You are their physicians, they will certainly listen to you. And that way, my women will certainly benefit. That's my request to you. Once again, I thank you very much for your kindness. Thank you very much.
Way back in 1975, Dr. Savithri Subramanyam was an assistant to Dr. A.K. Kurian Joseph. In those days, gynecologists had to necessarily undergo a training in surgery. I do not know about the present system and I do not want to comment. When Dr. Savithri Subramanyam and A.K. Kurian Joseph does surgery, there is no emergency call for the assistant surgeon from Stanley Medical College. Whereas our counterparts, when I was a house surgeon, hey, who put on urologist, bladder cut pantanda, urethra cut pantanda, then inferior vena cava cut pantanda. We have to do 24 hours night duty in the blood bank of Arasaram Hospital. That's after she's not only an excellent teacher, but an excellent surgeon. Thank you.